Do those three things go together? The U.S. Court of Appeals for the Ninth Circuit in San Francisco just ruled that political ads can be run on public television. It lifted an FCC ban on these ads from public broadcasting, saying that the FCC had violated the First Amendment by stifling free speech. So joining us for a fair and balanced debate on this is the CEO of the Legacy Companies and radio talk show host Neil Asbury and blogger from the National Catholic Register, Jennifer Fulweiler. Thanks so much for being here, guys.
Thank you, Allie. Thanks for having me.
Okay, so political attack ads running on PBS, which theoretically means that they could be on during Sesame Street while your kids are watching. Jennifer, is that okay?
Not at all. As a parent, I'm really concerned about this. I mean, what, I'm going to put my kid in front of Sesame Street and instead of coming back singing the ABC, she's going to be ranting about Senator so-and-so's record on health care reform? I don't like it.
That's funny. Neil, what do you think about that possibility?
Well, our kids are getting bombarded by sex and drugs and promiscuity, and we don't want them to be part of the political process. Wouldn't it be a great thing is if they were watching Sesame Street and they saw what the political process was all about, they went back to their parents and they started to ask questions. I don't think it's ever too early to get them engaged. After all, they're going to inherit this democracy of ours, and they're much smarter than we think they are. I think that they can make this a much better place much earlier than we give them credit for.
Well, I mean, Neil, you have a great point. And obviously, when we were young, Schoolhouse Rock did a great job of showing how a bill, you know, travels through Congress and becomes a law. But do your kids really need to see Granny being pushed off the cliff like one of those attack ads, Jennifer?
No, absolutely not. And I think the key thing is that, you know, those great Schoolhouse Rock shows, they made an effort to be unbiased, but these are very biased messages. And as parents, that is our job to educate our children about the political arena, not some political attack ads.
Yeah, so I mean, Neil, is there too much of an agenda in these attack ads for kids to just really be learning about the pure political process?
Let's remember that they're not the content. They're ads, right? But our kids need to be exposed to the political process, the good, the bad, and the ugly, and go back to their parents and start asking questions. And I think it's a very positive thing to bring kids into the political process as early as we can. You know, having an educated electorate is essential to a functioning democracy. And I think it's wonderful that we would bring kids into the process sooner than later and let them go back to their parents. Hey, look, let them ask the questions. And yes, they are gonna see some pretty nasty things, but I don't think it's any worse than all the other stuff that they see in our media. There's a lot more things that is hurting our kids that we need to clean up before we get to political ads.
Jennifer, let me read to you what the judge on the Ninth Circuit, how he justified this decision. He says public issue and political speech in particular is at the very core of the First Amendment's protection. Political advertisements pose no threat of commercialization. A ban on such advertising, therefore, cannot be narrowly tailored to serve the interest of preventing the commercialization of broadcasting. In other words, it sounds like PBS and NPR, they're trying to protect against your kids seeing commercials, but not political attack ads. Is that a good justification?
I don't think so at all. I mean, the whole idea behind public television was supposed to be that it's immune to these market forces. It's immune to the chase for dollars. And so they're incentivized to put out some real quality stuff and not be competing for these dollars. And so in addition to what our kids might be seeing, I worry that this could even incentivize these sorts of stations to start ditching their quality children's programming and start doing things that might bring in more campaign dollars.
All right, guys, we have to leave it there, but we do want to hear what our viewers think. You guys have had a great debate. Neil Asbury, Jennifer Fulweiler, thanks so much for coming in and talking about this.
Thanks.